Welcome back to Let's Play The Outer Worlds. Peril on Gorgon. Continuing. We're already here, but now we're going from Ambrose Manor to the Gorgon landing pad.
We are now in orbit above Gorgon.
Indeed. Hi.
Good to see you, boss.
I don't think this will be anything new. Okay. Just never see him walk around down here. Well, I'm gonna take the same two again, at least for now. So we have beasts, marauders, and abandoned test subjects or something.
Look at those stars. Don't it make you feel small in the best way?
What is the best way of feeling small? Okay, there's some kind of alarm blaring. Let's take a look back here. And I hope we're safe up here anyway. Light pistol mark 2? 3? Whatever it said. I think it's one I've seen before. Sentry saber mark 3. Wow, this place is really eerie, isn't it? I see that axe. Well, we got a dead person. I hear sprats. Well, there's the sprat shack that way. We're supposed to go that way. Huh. I gotta hold this. Yeah. Still getting used to the controls. Where do my party members go? What is that? Oh, there they are. They found me. That's a slow one, isn't it? All right. Empty. Khalil Chakrun.
I got supplies if you need them. No one lasts long on Gorgon unprepared.
Okay, survival goods. Well, I guess if I open that, yeah, he's not gonna like that.
You looking for supplies, stranger? A stock up here. If you run low on bullets out in Gorgon's far reaches, there ain't no one round here liable to help you out. Let me know if you're looking for something particular.
I think I have plenty of ammo. Take it that evacuation alarm isn't urgent?
Huh? Oh, you don't gotta worry about that. It's got something to do with that scrapped Spacer's Choice project from way back. Damn alarm's been hollering at us for 5 years if it's been a day.
Really?
You know, I don't dream anymore. It's all, please evacuate in an orderly fashion.
Well, there's a dead body back there. Maybe that was a marauder? What if you moved away from the incessant alarm?
Folks coming and going pass right by me here. It's the ideal spot to do business. Apart from the obvious. And there ain't much I can do to shut that control terminal down. I know, because even Von Hoffman couldn't bash it in. And I seen that tough son of a gun throw man clean across the Sprat Shack one time like he were a toss ball.
Hmm. Well, I do want to see if I can shut it off. I don't have a... option to tell him now. What can you tell me about Project Gorgon?
Only that Spacer's Choice shut it down in a big hurry. From what I heard, some of their folks got left behind even. Don't seem like the project ended well.
Uh-huh. Be kind of stupid to say this at this point.
Found a pickaxe in the mine like none I've ever seen before. Could be awful useful if you're the violent type.
Is it really a pickaxe then? 33% discount. Talking about this thing? Cleaver? Oh no, maybe that. Handy deconstruction tool. The unfortunate... The original brand name, Auto Unfortunato, never caught on. Wow! Look how expensive it is. I don't even have enough. That's crazy. Alright. I'll sell the junk. Didn't I want to save something? In junk? No, I'll sell it. Alright. I have that much Adreno. Good God. Body attributes. Mind attributes. Base health. So it's mind attributes also. Alright, I think we'll keep the rest. Well, thanks. That's a take. Very tempted by some of this stuff. This mean I'm not seen, right, by him? Renovated exo helmet. Is this the same? No, this goes up somewhere else. So I can just sell him this stuff back. Oh. Oh, that's not real. Not real! That goes out. You can see me, right? Hard to tell when they can see you or not. Want some algae lager and purple berry liqueur?
Hey again, stranger. What can I get you? All sorts of salvage and weapons, and plenty of.
Ultra. I'm selling him his own stuff back. Alright, so this stuff is critical damage. I try to keep one of everything. Base health. Armor. Status effect. Tactical time dilation. So I got that. Personality. Body attributes. 20 of them. Adrena time. Mind attributes. 200% health. Personality. Here as well. So we're going to get rid of these. Mind attributes. 20% natural health, base health, base health. So this is body also. Then I have something else, base health 25%. Yeah, this. Okay. Thanks. Sold the poor guy his own stuff pack. You know, I'm wondering though, that lift. Does this go anywhere interesting? What's a whole second level? Oh, there's a sprat shack, okay. Okay, we've got a thingy to read. Stellar Freighting Argosy. Gorgon, a Spacer's Choice property. Main menu. Welcome user. Tran D. Notice, electricity rationing in effect. By accessing this terminal, you consent to paying one bit per every option selected. Am I really be spending one bit? I mean, I don't care, just wondering. Check electricity rationing bit. Or, what'd it say? Bill, not bit. Processing. Employee Tran Dominic currently owes 9510 bits. Okay, so I'm running up his bill, not my own. Pay the bill? Bits removed from employee account. Tran Dominic currently owes 0 bits. Account paid in full. Congratulations on being a stellar team player, Tran D. It's not my own, right? No, I paid his bill with his own money. Shipment history. Please select from the following options. Shipment history pull request logged. Outgoing shipments. Displaying departed freight. Okay, shipment ID. Shipping manifest. Ship name Perseus. Voyage Terra 2 Loop E1. Port of load Gorgon. Port of discharge. Okay, so it's going from Gorgon to Edgewater. Discharge date 2,000 cartons containing redacted. 3 discharge staff, 5 reassigned staff. I wonder what the cartons add. Alert! Manifest content exceeds the recommended maximum weight of this vessel. Shipment ID. Next one. Perseus. Voyage Terra 1 Loop. SB4. Okay, loading from Gorgon going to Stellar Bay. Contents. 100 cartons containing prototype redacted. 2 tons of raw ore of redacted. 15 reassigned staff. Again, maximum weight warning. Incoming shipments. Vessel name Ethics Gradient. Voyage Charybdis Loop G3. Okay, loading up a Tartarus. Discharging a Gorgon, of course. They're going to all be discharging a Gorgon. This one will tell us what it is. 350 cartons containing 100 units each of sterile injection ampules. 30 high-pressure steel cylinders containing oxygen and 25 volunteers. Huh. What are they going to inject people with so many things? So many injections. Okay. Vessel name Profit Margin. That's quite a name. Coming from Byzantium, 3 corporate security squads containing 3 fire teams each, 500 rounds of light ammunition, 2,000 rounds of heavy ammunition, and 1 flat containing 10 units of Moonman Standee. Is that like a mannequin or like a stand-up, like, I don't know. So the best choice is the only choice, yeah. Oh, GIMSI. Gorgon Internal Messaging System Interface. Thank you for using GIMSI, your employee Employer, sanctioned messaging system. Friendly reminder, your messages are company property. Unauthorized reproduction, distribution, or deletion of GIMC content may result in early termination of your employment contract. Again, such great people to work for. Incoming messages from C. Mostly? The Tran D from Mostly C. Subject, various observations on the Argosy's rate of export with a reprimand. Mr. Tran, are you aware of the concept of relativity? This is a rhetorical question. I am aware that Spacer's Choice training does not include business philosophy in its curriculum. Consider this a remedial education. Broadly, relativity is an economic idea that describes productivity in terms of relationship. No, it isn't. For example, from your point of view, the Argosy's, i.e. your freight depot, exports shipments of a perfectly reasonable rate. However, from the point of view of your enterprising colleague, i.e. S. Raymond, or Reynard, sorry, the Argosy's freight depot exports shipments at a positively pathetic rate. If a single one of your colleagues is capable of three times your productivity, then relative to your colleague, the Argosy freight depot is a failure. The rubric of your success is measured relative to your fastest, strongest, and most productive colleagues. Do you understand? Please take a moment to consider the contents of this message and commit them to your heart. Furthermore, please select one of the following reprimands below and append it to your permanent record. A. The quality of your work is unacceptably low by Spacer's Choice standards. B. The quality of your work is unacceptably low relative to that of your colleagues, or C, by receiving an official reprimand on your permanent record, you have violated Spacer's Choice Code of Conduct, which will result in an official reprimand. Work fortifies the spirit. C, mostly. It's a funny last name. So you have to choose a reprimand. And this reprimand results in another reprimand. Was it referring back to the same reprimand? I don't even know. Okay, that's it for incoming. Wait, didn't mean to do that. Outgoing. To S. Raynard. Subject, efficiency. Buddy, I don't understand how you manage to log three times the number of shipments I do out of that miserable shack you call an office, but you need to cut it the hell out. Mostly he's been poking at the Argosy ship rate numbers again, and now he started asking why Lewis and I can't pack as quickly together as you alone. I'm thinking maybe I should tell him you're dipping into the supply of the prototype Adrena time. I don't think he'd like that, do you? Maybe you are. If that's the case, well, maybe you ought to come lend me and Lewis a hand when we load up the next haul of test subject corpses. Get yourself a real good view of what Chem's wonder drug does. I wonder if those are what all the injection needles are for. Prototype Adrena time. Could be. And here's one of the loading screens too, like a new loading screen. It's kind of a spoiler, I guess. Archive messages from L. Velasquez. Subject, shipping inquiry. High priority. Dom. Okay, so now we know his name's Dom, or Dominic Tran. You gotta help me out. The Monarch delivery's gone MIA, and now the big guy at corporate is messaging my personal terminal looking for answers. Not Mostly, not Goodfellow. That seersucker suit-wearing MF-er from Byzantium. Bancroft. Okay. Bancroft. Your kid cousin still works in Cascadia, right? Do you think he could hoof it over to Stellar Bay and just, I don't know, poke around the port, see if it's there? The shipment ID's Z42ML8TXY, the transport we packed last week. I know it's a lot to ask, and you know how I feel about bragging for handouts, but I swear the law, if I looked out my door, that Bancroft guy would be there in the street, slapping a wrench against his palm like a mob boss in one of those bootleg serials from Groundbreaker. Please, man, you gotta know, You know how fond I am of my kneecaps. That's something I could see, I could imagine Christopher Walken reading that. Because that's in there. People just dropped these cigarettes and liquor over here. And ammo. Well, these crates just blew open, I don't know. Oh. Guys, help yourselves. It's like ammo all over here and liquor and oh, there's a road going down. So there's more than one way up here. Sprat shack exterior. Magpicks. Alright, I don't know what to expect in this sprat shack.
Quietly now.
So let's be ready. See, there's that Adrena time. Hello?
Come here. Let's have a chat.
Okay.
All right, inspection time. Look at my eyes for as long as you can without blinking. Starting now.
What's this all about?
Did I stutter? Just do as I say.
All right, I'll have a staring contest then.
Good. Look up. Now look down.
This is stupid.
You wouldn't say that if you were in my shoes. Now are you gonna cooperate? Look up, then look down.
Sure, I'll do it.
You're doing swell. Now, name and occupation.
You first.
I could do without the sass, but that's good enough. You're cleared. That was a sanity check. If you had changed like the others, it'd be in your eyes. You'd also be drooling, cursing, and making a mess of the place.
Well, you think that would give it
Welcome
away.
Welcome to the Sprat Shack. You can head on downstairs.
What do you mean when you said people had changed?
Every day, salvagers and scrappers set out to comb the ruins and make their fortune. The ones who come back, they aren't always the same men or women who left. They change. Never for the better.
What happens when people change?
First they get real twitchy and paranoid, shouting at folks who aren't there. Then they smell like they soiled themselves on account of how they soiled themselves.
Makes sense.
After that, they're gone. Nothing but animals wearing human skin. Seen it happen myself. It's never pretty.
Hmm. Well, that's a little worrying. Being as we're gonna be going out in the wild soon. Where exactly am I?
This is the Sprat Shack, the most remote watering hole in the system. Rule number one, no fighting. Rule number two, wipe your feet on the way downstairs. We're the only hospitable place on this rock. I want to keep it that way. That's why we have rule number three. When people change, they stay outside where they belong.
Okay. Let me ask you something else.
Just don't ask me to dance.
What do you know about Gorgon?
Something bad happened here. Spacer's Choice was developing chemicals. The kind with nasty side effects. Marauders outnumber the rest of us 10-1. Either they came from Gorgon, or something draws them here. I don't know which is worse. This place is under a dark cloud, stranger. That's all I know. If you want the history of the Sprat Shack, talk to Lex behind the bar.
What kinds of people come to the Sprat Shack?
This is a sublight bar, so most of our regulars come to plunder the old labs.
Hmm.
The facility's locked up behind miles of red tape, so progress is slow. A lot of time to drink and reevaluate, then venture out and try again.
Red tape, though. So it's locked up, but by red tape. What do you do around here?
Bouncer, bodyguard, law enforcer. I make sure the Sprat Shack gets only the highest caliber of clientele.
That's us.
Yes, your presence screams high class.
We get a lot of brand loyal corporate types and a lot of cutthroat freelancer types. Both sides have their share of dirty scoundrels. And I hate dirt.
All right. Well, thanks.
Stay cool.
Well, here you got Sprats in the Sprat Shack. Shouldn't be surprising. I guess we shouldn't steal things with them sitting right there. Behind him, however, is a different story.
His birth.
Who?
A true den of iniquity. How refreshing.
A rotten hive of scum and villainy? Bar patron. So you got a whole other level we skipped past, at least maybe two? I wasn't paying attention. Hi.
You here for salvage or merchandise?
Yes.
Are you my agent on the ground?
Sorry?
I've been sent to meet a certain someone about a certain piece of merchandise. They're supposed to use a secret code phrase.
Can't help you. I'm just here to drink.
That's the code phrase. It is you.
Quiet down. You're making a scene. This rock ain't much to look at, but it's our rock.
This is a family business. Chin up, look sharp.
Nice lipstick. Really, this just goes behind. Is anyone back here? No. Right.
You're an artist, Captain.
Let's see, there were a lot of red things showing up. And now they're not red anymore.
I saw that.
Oh no!